All right, this is solving basic linear equations, and the reason they're called basic is this is the standard form for our linear equation. And the way we solve it is this. You're going to subtract that 6 from both sides. The way you can look at this problem is that we have 3x's plus 6 equals 18. So we literally have 3x's sitting here, x plus x plus x, and then you have a 6 and an 18. And what we have to do is get rid of this 6 because it's on our x side. So we want to isolate the x all by itself. Okay? So by subtracting the 6, we now have just 3x's. And then 18 minus 6 is 12. Next step is to divide. So we divide by 3. You divide by whatever number is next to them. And that's the pattern. You just want to get in that motion where you add or subtract, divide. Add or subtract, divide. So like over here, we add or subtract. So on the x side, what's being added or subtracted? The 5. Good. So we add a 5. That way they'll cancel. And we're left with negative x equals 7. Step 2 is to divide by whatever's next to the x. So we'll put a 1 there. That way we have it. So we divide by negative 1. And we get x equals negative 7. And that's it. It's that pattern over and over and over again. Alright, so you're going to add or subtract and then divide. Here, I'll give you one more. Just some random one I'll make up. 4x equals 5. 4x plus 5 equals 9. So, we subtract first. Remember, we focus on the x side. So there's a 5 and a 4. We subtract the 5 away. So that gives us 4x equals 4. And then we divide by 4. So x equals 1. And that's it. That's our pattern, and that's what you want to do. So I want you to try these two for me. Hit pause on the video. Give them a shot. And here's what you should get. So on the x side, we're going to take away the 5. So 8 take away 5 is 3. And then we bring the 3x's down. So 3x, we divide that away, and we get 1. And then on the other one, we minus the 5 because that's what's being added or subtracted. And then what's next to the x is a negative 3. So we divide by negative 3, which gives us 3. And now if we check it, remember it's 3 times what plus 5 equals 8. So 3 plus 5 equals 8, and that is a check. 100% correct. Over here, negative 4 equals 5 minus 3 times 3. So 5 minus 9, and 5 minus 9 is negative 4. Checks out perfectly. We're just trying to make sure our equation works out perfectly. All right, here's the reason why we're doing it in this order. Think about it again. If we have 3x's plus 2 equals 5. Okay? Actually, just to make it a little nicer, 3x plus 2 equals 8. So what this looks like is this. You have x's. You have 3 of them, right? So I'm going to draw the x's as circles. 1, 2, 3. Okay? And then over here we have 2. So that's 1. Let's do a different color. We'll do those in rectangles. Squares. 1, 2. And then over here we have 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay? Now we have an equation here. So let's draw the line, and these are two weighted sides. Okay, so this has to be made equal. So we're trying to find out what one of these circles equals in terms of one of these squares. So the first thought is, okay, well, if I get rid of these two little squares, we're left with just the circle. So let's do that. 1, 2. But if I get rid of 2 on this side, I have to get rid of 2 over there. Okay, now what? So we have 3 of these, and they equal 6 little rectangles. Well, if I pair them up, now we can see what 1 is equally. 1 equals 2 rectangles, 1 equals 2 rectangles, 1 equals 2 rectangles. This pairing is division. We're dividing it into 3 parts. That's what we just did. This is divided into three parts. So looking at it mathematically, when you do these little equations, we minus 2 because we took away 2 from each side. And then we divided it into three parts, which gives us 1x equals 2. That's what we got. Divided into three parts. And that gave us 1 equals 2, 1 equals 2, 1 equals 2. That's it. This is your basic equation. It's the one that you want to practice the most. And it's that constant pattern you want to get into until you're very, very quick at it.